In this lesson, we're going to get the camera moving and following the player. Currently, the camera is stationary. We need to tie the camera to the player game object. We can do this by making our camera a child of the player game object. Drag the camera in the hierarchy onto the player. In simple terms, we can think of the parent-child relationship as attaching the child to the parent in a one-way connection. If the parent moves, the child will move and maintain its relationship to the parent. If the child moves, however, the parent will not be moved. This is a fairly typical setup with the camera as a child of the player. If we move the player in the editor, we can see that the camera's field of view, represented by the gray box, moves with it. If we change the player's rotation, the camera rotates as well. Let's test this in play mode. We enter play mode and use the arrow keys to move. But when we hit the wall, the UFO begins to spin and things go a little crazy. What's happening here? Well, with the camera as a child of the player, even though the camera is not moving at all relative to the player's game object, the player's game object is rotating, so the camera's point of view rotates with it. This may make us, or our audience, queasy. This is clearly not an ideal setup for this particular game. In a typical setup, the camera, as a child of the player game object, will always be in a position relative to its immediate parent, and this position will be the parent's position in the game, modified or offset by any values in the child's transform. In our case, we can't have the camera as a child of the player, so let's detach it by dragging it above the player in the hierarchy. Our offset value will be the difference between the player game object and the camera. Now, we need to associate the camera with the player game object, not as a child, but with a script. With the main camera still highlighted, let's use the Add Component button to add a new script. And let's name the script Camera Controller. If we type the name of a component in the search box and it's not found, it will prompt us with the New Script button. This is a shortcut which allows us to quickly create scripts by typing their name and clicking New Script. Click Create and Add, or simply hit the Return or Enter key to confirm our selection. As we saw earlier, this way of creating a script will create that script asset on the root or top level of our project view. Let's put Camera Controller in the Scripts folder and then open it for editing. We need two variables here, a public game object reference to the player and a private vector 3 to hold our offset value. Type public game object player. Then type private vector 3 offset. Offset is private because we can set that value here in the script. For our offset value, we will take the current transform position of the camera and subtract the transform position of the player to find the difference between the two. This will be the offset value. So in start, we can make offset equal to our transform position minus the player's transform position. Type offset equals transform.position minus player.transform.position. When written like this, transform references the transform of the game object that this script is attached to. It's worth noting that as this script is attached to the same game object as the camera component, transform.position references the transform's position for the camera as they are both attached to the same game object. In update, we'll set the transform position of our camera to our player's transform position plus the offset. This will happen every frame because it's in update. Type transform.position equals player.transform.position plus offset. This means, as we move our player with the controls on the keyboard, that each frame before displaying what the camera can see, the camera is moved into a new position aligned with the player object, just as if it were a child of that object, except that it will not be spinning around the game board as the parent object spins. However, update is not the best place for this code. It is true that update runs every frame, and in update each frame we can track the position of the player's game object and set the position of the camera. However, for follow cameras, procedural animation, and gathering last known states, it's best to use late update. Let's change update to late update. Late update runs every frame just like update, but it is guaranteed to run after all items have been processed in update. So when we set the position of the camera, we know absolutely that the player has already moved for that frame. So let's test this. Let's save our script and return to Unity. First, we need to create a reference to the player game object by dragging the player game object onto the player slot in the camera controller's component. Enter play mode. And now we get the behavior we want. The camera follows the UFO without rotating when we collide. In the next assignment, we'll finish the basic play area by creating and placing our special pickup objects.